Good morning, friend. I'm very thankful, Haryana Chartered Association of Physiotherapy, for giving me the platform to speak about my experience and share my knowledge with you all. And today my topic is the role of robotic gait trainer in neuro rehabilitation. So, what is the role of latest technologies will play importance in the recovery of patients? So, the robotic techniques will play a very important role, and they help in enhancing the recovery of the patient. So let's go. We have a short of time, so we could directly go to our main topic. And so, role of robotic gait trainer in neuro rehabilitation. The neuro rehabilitation is basically a multidisciplinary team round. It consists of a neurosurgeon, neurophysician, neurocardiophysiotherapist, occupational therapist, speech and dysphagia therapist, psychologist, neuro nurse, orthotist, and social worker. So, robotic gait trainer. What is the benefit of robotic gait trainer in neuro rehabilitation? So this is the robotic gait trainer geo evolution, which we are using in Max Hospital circuits. The geo system is a robotic device that enabling gait and impaired patient to learn the ability to walk and regain independence through mobility. How is work? There's a force platform is there. When I show you the videos of the robotic gait trainer, then you can find out what kind of platform is there. The end effector system, the foot initiate the movement of knee and hip according to the current gait phase. So what is our normal gait cycle? There's a system initiate the movement of the knee, natural gait pattern, physiological muscle activation. Main benefit, specific repetitive practice on floor walking. It is the only device in the world which is you help in doing the straight climbing and customized movement within the gait cycle. 800 steps within 20 minutes of session, it will help. And full control over gait variables. So you can also see the step length, cadence, dynamic, body weight support, hip facilitation, and you can also change in computer, which I will talk on later on. Passive mode of movements are there. Active mode of movements are there. Active assisted therapy modes of movements are there. So unique advantage. Short setup times. Patient ready within 5 minutes. Stair climbing up and down. It will help the stair climbing. World only device to offer these features. One therapist to cooperate. You will don't require too much of manpower forces. Only one therapist you will need. So you can efficient allocation of the resources. So clinical rationales. Right now I will tell you how this robotic device will have different from the conventional therapy. If you go with the conventional therapy, maximum patient a therapist can be used 50 to 100 steps per session, not more than that. Minimum manual data capture, labor intensive, there's a lot of therapists will be required during the movements and assistance support, variable qualities and risk of falling. And there's a study which is sure there is no better outcome, and number of repetitions is still insufficient, which is used to develop a neuroplasticity of the brain. Treadmill therapy, which are normally the centers are using, body weight support, 350 steps per sessions, stair climbings not possible, up to 3 PT, variable quality, and demanding of the therapist and patients. So, treadmill therapy is not superior to conventional therapy gait training on the floor. As per the normal research said, they are the same result. Treadmill therapy in stroke patient. Conclusion. No statistically significant effect of treadmill training without body weight support were detected. Key point of meta-analysis, the quality of training is not always ensured. It's still too demanding for the therapist. It's still too few repetitions. So, still the conventional body weight support is not that much effective. And these are the researches which will compare with the body weight support and conventional therapy. And clinical evidence, there's a lot of study which will be done. I will show you this electromagnetic assistant training for walking after stroke, manual ASL. And patient would receive, according to the study, patient would receive robotic assisted device for gait training in combination physical therapy after stroke had higher chance of reach independence walking. So these are the research study. You can also look after journals and the abstract of these conditions. So patients who were not able to walk within first 3 months after the episode seem to have a most favorable outcome with robotic gait trainer. So what are the advantages of robotic gait trainer is that the intervention can be prescriptive and repeatable and reproducible. The key benefits of robotic gait trainer are strengthen muscles, bones, preventing muscle atrophy, offer a realistic simultaneous of the physical gait patterns with benefit of ideal joint position, symmetrical weight bearing on the both feet, allow isolating and generating specific phase of walking cycle. It also helps to stairs ascending and descending, which is very difficult in normal treadmill gait training and normal stair climbing training. There's a lot of therapies will be required and there's a risk of fall of patient is very high. Allow patient to enhance mobility independence in daily living. It will help to enhance mobility independently in daily living. And the number of steps which patients are doing during the normal 20-minute session, no conventional therapy will not give that much of movement. Edge over other technologies. Improve clinical outcome in less time. Improve walking patterns, pace with less energy conservation. Better safety and comfort. Reducing the risk of patient and clinician injuries. And it is the adjustable assistance level. Upgrade the intensity as per tolerance level of the patient. Benefit for therapist. The robotic gait trainer require very short setup of times. You can make the patient ready for within 5 to 10 minutes. It will open access to the patient and control over gait setting. Possibility to track patient progress over time. You can have a data records of the patient, how much step is done, how much cadence, what is the step length. Robotic gait trainer is equipped with force sensor that registers the amount of robot generating force assisting the patient to follow the predefined walking pattern. It also allows delivering continuous support for the leg in a physiological walk pattern, high repetition accuracy and prolonged training duration compared to manual walking training. A number of 800 repetitions are considered to be the standard number of repetitions to be performed for task-specific repetitive approach. So according to the studies, they said if you go with the convention, at least 800 repetitions should be there to develop neuroplasticity. And the patient has to wear robust shoes like gym shoes and therapeutic shoes. Only you just need to patient wear shoes and no other gadgets will be required because all the support will be given by the robotic gait trainer. A compressive assessment is carried out. Well, what are the prerequisites which we using while getting a patient ready for robotic? Assessment should be carried out throughout the necessary contraindications. If there is any kind of contraindication will be there, which I will talk on later on, then you should avoid robotic gait trainer. To avoid any vasovagal issues, patients are initially taken on a standing frame tilt table. So if your patient is not able to walk from last 2 months, so first you can make him stand on tilt table and or a standing frame to prevent any kind of postural hypotension. Once patient maintain the erect position for 20 minutes, if the patient is able, normally what we do, we make the patient 2-3 days used to get a standing pattern for at least 20 minutes without any syncope, giddiness. They are taken for the robotic gait trainer with sports shoes. And normally we can do a trial run for 5 to 10 minutes to then to check on any discomfort or adjustment required, which we normally follow in routine whenever we treat our patient. Thereafter the patient is started with the session. The few session will be 20 to 30 minutes, then the duration will be increased and step. Normally I see a lot of my patient after taking 5 to 6 session, they will be do 2000 steps per day. So you can find a big difference in that. Within 45 minutes, they will do 2000 steps and stair climbings. So there's a whole different which you can feel by the use of robotic gait trainer and recovery of patient. And weight bearing, it also have the force plate which help you to get the weight shifting of the patient. The patient know where he putting the weight of his body, and you can see on the computer. I will show the video in which we can I will tell you, explain you the things. What are the indication? Which kind of patient we can take for the robotic gait trainer? Paraplegia, paraparesis, hemiplegic, hemiparesis, stroke patient, spinal cord injury patient, multiple sclerosis, cerebral palsy, Parkinson's disease, and traumatic brain injury. And what are the contraindication? Orthostatic circulation problems, we have to avoid unstable fractures, severe osteoporosis, cooperation patient with reduced cooperation, aggressive behavior, psychotic illness and neurotic dysfunction, pregnancy, severely fixed contractures, which may be lead to injury. So that way we don't avoid using robotic gait trainer. Cardiac contraindications, open skin lesion in the area of lower limbs and torso, severe vascular disorder of the lower limbs, and epileptic patients. This is the screen which we where we use the program, the computer screen on the side of the computer. Standing up protocols made allow easy, a quick access to the treatment designed especially for the specific clinical conditions such as stroke, Parkinson, traumatic brain injury, incomplete spinal cord. So the protocol will be there which you can choose. There's a visual feedback is there, virtual scenario is there. Robotic gait trainer offer the core rehabilitation function of the floor, walking and partial movements. With adjustable settings such as cadence, you can adjust the cadence, you can adjust the step length, ankle angle. If you want to change anything of that, you can change. Predefined disease specific program allow maximum available therapy time. There's a different kind of modes will be there. There's active mode is there, which help the patient, allow the patient to self-initiate the gait. Simultaneously by overcoming a pre-selected resistance threshold. This mode increases the patient to actively participate during the therapy session in order to maximize the therapeutic outcome. And there's active assisted, which will help and assist the patient during the movement. And there's a unique feature in this robotic gait trainer is partial movement, which allow isolating and generating a specific phase of walking cycle. So in conventional therapy, if you see about the stroke patient, normal conventional therapy, we do 50 to 100 step. And people who are doing work in neurology, they can find out the difference. Yes, normally the patient will do 50 to 100 step only. Treadmill training, 300 to 400 step. But with robotic gait trainer, it will give you 1200 to 2000 steps per session. So there's a way, lot of difference. There's a different study which will show how robotic gait trainer is effective as compared to the conventional therapy and the treadmill therapy. And this is also outcome measure will be there. You can use some outcome measures which are using before and after the therapy. The therapist can also use those outcome measures. There's a bunk balance scale, modified Barth index, function independence measure, modified function ambulatory care category, and modified river mid mobility index. These are the scales which you can use while treating a patient. Then you can also get a function outcome result within a patient. So normally we use one or two scales, like sometimes we use function independence measure, we can use Barth index. So these, why use this course? So to check out the difference, see if the patient is able to walk up to from 800 to 2000, that's not show sure he is able to walk more because the machine is assisting. But by calculating those scores and the function outcome measures, you can tell the attendant also, and you can also get the result and for your research purpose, ki what are the things you're getting out. So these are the separate thing which we used to do in our department. So I will suggest that research and studies will be very important. So this is the video.
Yes, sir.
You can let the patient wear the harness belt, so which can be used.
You shift the patient, then you shift the patient.
Then you shift the patient to the robotic gait trainer. This is a support which is given to the patient, and the harness should be attached to the belt. And then you can make the patient to stand. If the patient has a stroke and other things, you can strap the hands to the sidewheel. The strappers will become to strap the hands. Then you raise the sidewheels. And this is the screen which you see. This is standard protocol, partial movement, gait training, therapy devices. And there's a knee mounted device which will also be there, which is used for the spinal cord injury patient and the paraplegia patient. There's a screen will be there where you can find the patient will get the visual result. There's a gait, ankle and balance training will be there. You can see the result. The normal gait cycle, you can feel the normal. And you can feel the weight bearing of the leg here. So now when the heel strike, the weight will be there. The patient will be able to get actually himself. And the patient will be do more movements on the weight shifting on the one side. Then there is a program of stair climbing. You see, this is a single weight shifting program. Partial. The patient able to do partial movement, so you can able to patient alert the patient to shift the weight.
Stair climbing.
There's a stair climbing will be there, which I show you. So this is where, if you see how easily the patient able to do those things. If you give them, it's a simple thing which we require four people while doing a stair climbing. If any of the new reactors, they can find the difference ki how easy and eye comfortable the patient able to learn the gait pattern in a proper normal gait setting. This is a descending mode, descending stair climbing. There's a visual scenario which we are using while training the patient so that they will also feel like at home. They feel like their normal walking. The visual assistant will be there. So these are the few things which I want you. So these are the simple things of robotic gait trainer which we are usually do while treating our patients. So right now I'm not wearing mask and other thing, but we follow proper rules. So that's why I'm proper off. We wear the gloves while treating a patient. We wear the goggles and proper protective equipment we are using while treating a patient. And still, whenever anybody of you are doing any kind of practice, you make sure that you also protect it. Because during this COVID time, we need to be extra careful because we properly follow the hand hygiene and other practice which are we use for to prevent any kind of infection, because if we are safe, then everything is safe. So this is the things which I am telling you about the robotic gait trainer. I hope you all people learn a bit of things which we are doing. These are the normal techniques which you follow practically in our setup, and I think these latest technologies play a very important role in the recovery of patients. So I will suggest you all to learn from the latest things and what of the things are in the market. Try for those things and suggest the patient who require, who are not feeling that kind of much benefit, so they can avail this kind of treatment in these kind of facilities. Thank you Dr. Mudgal for giving me the chance for sharing my knowledge.
Yes,
this is the robotic gait trainer which we are using in our department, and there's a belt will be there which is the patient will wear the belt, then we make the patient to shift with the wheelchair, and there's a frame will be there from where we can shift the patient, then there's a harness will be there where the belt will be tied up, then we make the patient stand with the belt and the use of the harness will lift the weight, then you fold the frame, and then you have to start with the gait training program. Then you see there's a knee support mounting braces will be there for paraplegia patient, which we are not using right now, but they are there for paraplegia patient. There's a screen will be there where you can see the weight shifting of the patient also. and this is the program which we are using, Gate Trainer. And this is screen and this is the robotic device. This is the normal gait training pattern which we calculate the step of the patient also coming on the screen. And the patient will see how his weight is shifting. On the both side, the black dot are explaining you about the weight of the shifting. And this is the activity chart, how much the patient is using passively, actively, active assisted. This activity chart will be tell us. Then this is partial weight bearing, where you can start with the partial leg movement. And this is helping patient on running the waist shifting. You can see how comfortably the patient is able to do with the assisted device, active device and passive mode. And you can also check out the body weight support, how the body weight is supporting with the harness. And then you can go with the stray climbing. The stray climbing program will be followed. And then this is the stray climbing program for ascending. You can see how comfortably the patient is doing. If the patient is a stroke, then you can try the strap, use the strap for the hand is hand tight. You can tie the hand with the strap. And the patient can follow up the climb of the stray. This is for the descending model, how we descend the stairs. You can see this is a normal practice which we are doing for our patient. This is a dummy patient we are using right now. And then there is another program that is visual scenario where the patient can be feel and he can feel that he is walking in a normal park, which gives his brain active and develop the neuroplasticity of the brain to make him feel like normal walking. Thank you for watching this video.